Hi, in this short tutorial we will cover how to update already installed Qt SDK. For this we will use Maintain Qt application. You can find it at your Start menu, All Programs, Qt SDK, and you have Maintain Qt SDK or Update Qt SDK. It's basically the same application. The application has started and it's checking on the internet for the latest components you can download and install. So we can see that next button is active, so it means that there are new updates available. From this menu we can choose what we wish to update, and we will download SDK maintenance package. Click update, show details, wait for everything to download. Okay, so the update is finished. We just click next. Restart, and we can check if there are some additional updates. So if we are back at this screen, this means that there are no new updates. Using Maintain Qt SDK, you can also uninstall Qt SDK. You just click on Remove All Components and Next, and you can also install additional packages by using Package Manager. So if you click next, you will see additional packages that you can install. So there are many additional options here. One of the most interesting to us is Qt Components. Qt components are a new feature in this Qt SDK, and they consist of user interface already developed controls like on-off buttons and additional features like scrolls and lists that are optimized for mobile phones. By default, Qt quick components for the simulator are not installed. This means that you won't be able to run programs that use Qt Quick components in Qt Simulator. You should definitely install them. To do this, click on Qt Quick components for Symbian Simulator and put the check next to Minimalistic GNU for Windows version of components. Afterwards, click Next. Whole process is shown in a separate video I have uploaded few days ago. The link is below. That's it. We have successfully updated Qt SDK. My next video will be covering simple Hello World application. So subscribe to my channel and click like if you like it. See you soon.